I have got an indoor circuit board of a mini split air conditioner. This circuit board is causing problems when running the blower motor. The problem is that when the display is attached to the circuit board, then the blower motor doesn't work. But when the display is removed from the circuit board, then the blower motor starts to work. Already someone has worked on this circuit board. The triac, which controls the blower motor, is missing from this circuit board. I will turn the circuit on the backside. A hot gun was used here, which caused this area of the circuit board to burn. I will install the triac and then check the rest of the circuit board. This model of the circuit board comes with different numbers of triac. This is another circuit board of the same model with this triac number installed. I have three different numbers of triac. Any one of them can be installed on this circuit board. Let me show you their numbers. The number of this IC is AQH2223. I will tell you the difference between them going further in the video. The next is AQH3223. The number of the next IC is R3BMF5. This triac ampere rating is 1.2 amperes. In the same way, this IC can also bear a load up to 1.2 ampere. This next IC can bear a load of 0.9 amperes. The more amperage, the less the chances of the IC going bad quickly. I can install any one of them between these two. I will place the IC inside this vacant area of the circuit board. I will align the pins. The IC is seated in the pads. I will solder the IC now. I have installed the new IC in the circuit board. The problem is that the owner didn't send me the display and the blower motor with this circuit board. I already have the display and blower motor, which I used to test circuit boards. If the display or the blower motor is faulty, the circuit board will work fine. But if the fault is in the circuit board, we will find it out. Let's install the blower motor and the display on the circuit board. This connector on the circuit board is for display. I will plug the display connector into it. And I will install the blower motor connector in the circuit. I have attached two types of connectors with my blower motor. This first connector is a little thin and is used in the circuit board. The second is this one, and mostly in these circuit boards, this thicker connector is used. The thinner connector is attached to this circuit board. I have attached both these connectors with the blower motor feedback wires. I will connect this connector to the circuit board's connector. The next phase is to install this connector in the circuit board's connector. But to install this, I will have to change the configuration of this connector. But if it is already okay, I will install it. If not, then I will have to change the position of the wires in the motor connector. Because if this connector is installed with the wrong connection in the circuit board, the blower motor will go damaged, or the circuit board will go bad. To avoid this, the connector's wire connections must be accurate. The wiring diagram is already made on the motor's body. The connections in the motor connection can be configured according to it. But if no wiring diagram is made on the motor. So for that, I have already made videos where you can learn how to find the connection in these blower motors, which will be linked at the end. But this blower motor has a wiring diagram on it. It is easy for me to find connections in this blower motor. In the diagram, a capacitor is between the red and black wires. The white wire is the common wire. I will check the common connection on the circuit board. The output from the triac is the common point on this circuit board. I will trace it out. The inductor pin is attached to this triac. Have a look at the print on the right, which is attached to the inductor. A print is joined on the left pin of the triac, which is the main phase for this IC. I will see the circuit from the backside. This is the first pin of the inductor. The second pin of the inductor is attached to the blower motor connector in the center. We have quickly traced the common pin of the blower motor in the circuit board. Now, in the blower motor's connector, a white wire is already attached in the center. In the diagram of this blower motor, the black and the red wires have a capacitor. This circular point with the white wire is the phase connection of the blower motor. The same circular point is made with the black wire, which means the black is the neutral wire for the blower motor. This is the capacitor symbol in the circuit board. This capacitor pin is attached to the pin of the blower motor connector in the circuit board. Let's have a look at the connector from the top. The capacitor is attached to the pin on the right side of the connector. Let's check that the neutral is present on this pin where I have placed the black probe. I must check the capacitor's pin on the right side for that. I have attached the probe of the multimeter with it. the red probe with the pin of the blower motor connector. The beep sound can be heard on these pins. This means that both these pins are connected. In the same way, I will check it with this point over here. And yes, the multimeter is beeping. This means the neutral is directly attached to this pin of the capacitor, and then to this pin of the blower motor. Now we are confirmed. The connection of the blower motor is okay. The red wire was attached to the capacitor, the black wire with the neutral. I will plug in the blower motor connector. I am putting some masking tape on the shaft of the blower motor to demonstrate the rotation when the motor works. I will install the electric connections to power the circuit board. First, I am installing the line wire. The third number pin on the relay is the common point. I have checked it. The following connection will be attached to the neutral terminal of the circuit board. This is the neutral terminal. Now, I will power the circuit board. The circuit board has powered on. It is off. I will turn it on with the remote. I have this universal remote. I will turn it on through it. It's not working on this code. I will press the set button. I will keep pressing it. The required code will match this air conditioning circuit board. The code has matched. 165 is the code for this air conditioner circuit board. I will press the enter button to set the code. I will lower the temperature. I have set it to 17 degrees. I will open this ambient thermistor from its case. I will heat it. The E3 error code has started showing on the air conditioner display. The blower motor didn't work. This is why this error code is shown on the display. The E2 error code has also started appearing on the display. This circuit board, which we are currently checking, shows two error codes on the display. The customer sent us this circuit board by saying that when the display is attached to the circuit board, it does not operate the blower motor. But as soon the display is detached, the circuit board starts to operate the motor. But I see that there is no such issue. It is turning on the display fine. The blower motor is not working. However, the thing to notice is that an E2 error is shown. The E3 error code is for the blower motor, and I know it. The E2 error in this circuit means the circuit has a problem with zero crossing. Due to one issue, a second problem could be displayed on the circuit board. First, I will try to fix the zero crossing problem. To fix the zero crossing error, I will tell you why the zero crossing error is shown. An optocoupler is installed in it, due to which the E2 error or zero crossing error is displayed. The microcontroller could not detect the voltages. Three optocouplers are installed on this circuit board. These two are used for communication. This third optocoupler is marked as IC5 on the circuit board. It is used for zero crossing on the circuit board. If these zero crossing signals do not reach the microcontroller, this is why this circuit board displays two error codes simultaneously. The optocoupler installed in the circuit board isolates the high and the low voltages. This is the same other circuit. I will explain the zero crossing optocoupler on this one. As I told you, this third optocoupler is for zero crossing. I have traced its prints in this circuit. The print from this pin is joined with the resistor, and the second is joined with the capacitor. It is grounded with this capacitor pin. This is a 100 kilo ohms resistor, and the trace from this resistor's pin is further connected to this resistor. The resistance value of this resistor is 150 kiloohms. I will move further, and it is connected with this point. A diode and resistor are connected here. I will see this cathode pin of the diode from the bottom side of the circuit. This is the cathode pin from the bottom, which is further connected over here. And what pin is this for? Let me show you from the top. The point I showed you is this one, for is written on it. We know that it is normally open terminal of this relay. The phase electric wire is attached to the three number terminal of this relay, and when the circuit turns on, this relay is switched on, and the external point connects with this four number terminal. The electricity then starts to pass through the outdoor unit, but I haven't checked till now whether the relay is passing electricity to the four number terminal. So, let's check this. I realized it earlier, but I didn't take it seriously. I didn't hear the voice of the relay when it was switching. The reason was the buzzer in the circuit board, so when we turned it on and off, due to the buzzer sound, I was not able to hear the relay switching sound. When the circuit is powered on, the sound of the buzzer is heard, and at the same time, the relay is turned on. Thus, the sound of the relay is suppressed. I will power on the circuit again. Let's see whether it works. I cannot confirm whether it is switching or not because sometimes the relay turns on, but its sound gets low. I will test it using this tester. First, I will check the electric supply at its phase terminal. The tester light is glowing on this terminal. The tester is not glowing on the second terminal of the relay. This means the relay has not turned on. I will use the multimeter now to test it. I have the multimeter on DC voltages. These two points are in series, where it switches on. These two pins are where the voltages are supplied to power the relay. I will turn on the circuit board with the remote, and let's check the required voltages on the relay. 11.50 voltages are present on these pins. This means that voltages are present to power the relay. But the relay is not working for any reason. I have powered off the circuit to desolder the relay out of the circuit board. I am adding some new solder to the relay pins to remove it from the circuit. The desoldering pump will suck the tin. The relay has come out of the circuit board. This is the new relay that I will install on the circuit board. I will solder the pin of the new relay. Let's test the circuit board. I have replaced this optocoupler here. The old optocoupler was fine. That got bad due to a mistake of mine. I will power on the circuit. The circuit board has powered on. I will turn it on with the remote. The temperature on the display is 17 degrees. The blower motor has started to work. This means the problem has been fixed. I am tired now, and I run on coffee. So buy it for me on Patreon. Click the link on the screen to visit. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.